beautiful strangers, welcome to Cat Reacts. I'm Cat, and I react to old films. Just depends on what you guys want me to react to. Today, I'm going to watch a film that was requested after some of you guys watched me react to Sister Act, a video that unfortunately YouTube took down due to copyright claims, and I have not been able to get back up. However, it is on my Patreon page. So, for those of you who are members of my Patreon, you can go and see it there. This particular film that I'm going to react to today is called Nuns on the Run. I don't think it has anything to do with Sister Act other than it has nuns in it. And I don't think it's a religious film. I hope not. The poster shows two guys. I'm not very well rehearsed in religious studies and all that, but I'm pretty sure that men cannot be nuns. I think they become monks or something. I think it's gonna be a comedy film. I will find out though. If you guys want to join me on the journey of discovering what this film is all about, then great, hop on and let's go.
You don't like this job any more than I do, do you?
Of course not.
Same old grind week after week.
Oi! Cup of tea over here, please!
What exactly are you? Are you in the mob or are you a criminal? What exactly are you? Like, what gives you the right to talk to the waitress like this?
Why don't we just pack it in?
Oh!
Stop! Hit the deck when you're dead!
Did the bullet fly in the air and then onto him, or did he have a heart attack? What the hell happened? I'm so confused.
You shot Louis, you arsehole!
Oh, shit.
You shot Louis? I don't know who Louis is, but you shot him?
Give me the money, you're a dead man!
Here, take it. You have it.
I don't care. Not mine.
And we got it!
Well, the people in that bank will be able to give an accurate description of you guys. Plus, there are cameras all over. Why didn't you hide your face? Rookie mistake.
It's just not like it used to be, Charlie. All those guns and violence.
So they are just chatting about being bank robbers, like they're being, you know, stockbrokers or something. This is just a day at the office for them.
I mean, none of us ever used to carry guns.
Do you want to tell Case we no longer want to be a part of his firm?
No.
I want to leave Mr. Casey's employment.
We didn't hear that.
I talked to Mr. Casey about it. He said no problem.
He won't let you go. You know too much.
Don't you think I can trust him?
No. This is not a business where you trust anyone, love.
I told him you guys wanted out as well.
Oh. Now, you see, why would you do that? They could have handled that business themselves.
Mr. Casey wants a word with you two boys.
Got something for you. It's in the car outside.
Oh! No, is that the guy, the car dealer? Oh, shoot. You know when your employee is a sick individual? Yeah.
He died suddenly.
What did he die of?
He wanted to work for somebody else.
Oh, natural causes.
Have you seen my glasses anywhere?
You got a customer.
Where? Can I get you a drink, sir?
Coffee, please.
What's wrong with her?
I'm sorry. I'm not wearing my glasses. I lost them last night.
Can I have your phone number?
No. Don't know who you are.
Finally, someone making sense. Way too often in films, if someone asks for a phone number, yeah, sure, no problem. And they just hand it over to a stranger. It's way too common.
Okay, here's mine. If you ever want anything, anything at all, just ask for Brian.
It's yours.
Oh, thanks. Oh, that's what you look like.
You're blind as a bat, love. I can see fine without my glasses, just like not far away. I can see fine, you know, near. I'm very nearsighted. If I take them down now, I can still watch the film, but I wouldn't be able to read signs, you know, far away.
You see, that drinking club belongs to the Triads. They're moving in from Hong Kong. We're going to take the real cotton gains away from them.
The Triads?
There's no risk.
No risk? The Triads?
Find out where they take the cash.
So the guys in the red Mercedes, they didn't realize they were being followed?
Why you follow us?
Oh, I take it back.
I don't know what you're talking about.
If you follow us again, I chop your arms off. Okay?
Okay.
You know what we ought to do? Steal the money for ourselves.
We grab the money for ourselves, we drive to the airport, and ole, we're in Rio.
Charlie!
You know, Faith.
Yeah, we've met.
Oh, hello.
Hello.
Sweetie, just keep your glasses on at all times.
You're in love with her.
I like her, that's all. What's wrong with that?
He's known her for, what, a day? How could he be in love with her?
They'll be armed, so we shoot to kill, right?
Yeah, shoot to kill.
What about Brian and Charlie?
Don't trust them no more. Think I'm gonna make tomorrow the last day on this planet.
Brian, they're gonna kill you!
Go away! I'm trying to commit a major crime!
Is this part of the plan?
Let me go!
There are four of you guys against the two of them. And you guys evidently had guns and everything as well. This hadn't been a fair fight for them if you had tried.
Who put in my car?
A bomb.
Are you off your trolley?
Yeah, they are. So I'm guessing those two were not professionally trained for guns because they could have just turned around and shot them. What's going on here?
Throw them bags over here.
It won't stop!
Why not?
Because it's a shitty car? What, all of a sudden now you're professionals? Why didn't you just shoot them before?
Where's Faith?
She's gone.
She made it in a taxi.
Why did he shoot her?
Was that a nun?
No, a ghost. Wow.
What are we gonna do?
Good question. I mean, the film is called Nuns on the Run, so I sort of expected this. But it's still weird. It's still really, really strange.
Have you got the airline ticket?
Where did they find this outfit? Like, how did they find an outfit that fit?
Shit, I left him in the car!
Christ, and we've got no alternative.
What do nuns do anyway?
They pray?
I do a look.
Okay.
Yes?
Hello, we're from Chipping Sodbury. We believe you're expecting us.
No.
Can we come in?
Suppose so. I'm the superior. Sister Liz is my name.
Good morning, Reverend Mother.
And what is your name?
Sister Inviolata of the Immaculate Conception.
And yours?
Sister Euphemia of the Five Wounds.
Do sit down.
Are they so feminine that she cannot realize that those are two men?
You thought we were expecting you.
Yes, did the documentation not arrive?
What documentation?
From our Mother Superior, the letter she sent to introduce us.
I don't recall such a letter. Still, you're very welcome. We run a teacher training college in this convent for 18 to 22-year-old girls. I will just find someone to show you round.
Never get away with this.
Brian, this is our only chance to go straight.
This is Sister Mary of the Annunciation. She will take you to your cells.
Beautiful. Why do nuns keep insisting on calling it cells? That's creepy. It's like they're in prison.
You couldn't lend us something more like what you're wearing, could you?
We've got loads of stuff for you in the basement. I'll lend you one of mine.
Yeah.
Why? Because we need to look just like them if we want to pass unnoticed. I've never been a nun before.
I hope not. I sincerely hope not. I'm just amazed that none of the nuns actually realize that those are two men.
I want that money. I want that girl alive to find out what she knows. And I want Brian and Charlie.
Dead!
Did you need to scream this? What is wrong with you?
Are you a nun?
Oh, very funny. What do you want?
Hello, sisters. I'm Father Seamus.
This is Sister Euphemia, and this is Sister Inviolata. They're staying here.
I'm very pleased to meet you, Sister Euphemia. If there's anything at all I can do for you, don't hesitate to call on me, day or night.
Now he creeps me out.
Father Seamus can't keep his hands to himself.
I knew it. I knew he was a pervert. I knew it.
That's disgusting.
Yeah.
So, I hear you're from Chipping Sodbury.
Yes.
I like the fact that they had his name be Father Seamus. Shameful Seamus. Shame, shame, shame.
I admit I enjoy women's company. There's nothing wrong with that, I hope, sister.
No, there's nothing wrong with that. Being a creep is.
Apparently there's been a bomb and some shooting in the street. I don't suppose you've seen anything unusual.
Was anything stolen? We don't know.
Why don't I just talk to all the other sisters? And if you can tell us who or what you're looking for, we'll tell you if we've seen it.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
And Mary, I'm afraid you and I must have a little talk right away.
I've got to give the girls their religious studies classes in 15 minutes, so
sit down, please.
What does Sister Mary do? Why is she so uncomfortable? Oh. Oh, she's a drunk. Yeah, that's not really good when you're a nun. It's not good, you know, in general, but it's extra bad when you're a nun.
I have to talk to Sister Mary here. Would you take her religious studies class for the third year girls?
Me?
Yes, in quarter of an hour.
How about having that old nun do it? The small one who looks to be more dead than alive.
What about her?
Yeah.
She's just hanging about.
I'm retired.
Just talk to the girls and answer their questions about the Trinity.
The Trinity?
Yeah, the Holy Spirit and Father and Son and all that. I don't know. I'm not religious. Never happened.
This young lady says she wants to be a teacher. I can't think why.
Let's go.
Let me out.
No.
I want to talk to Faith.
You can't. She can't know we're nuns.
Why not?
What if Abbott and Morley find her? I'm thinking of her. If she knows nothing, she's safe.
So they went from being bombers and bank robbers to teaching religious studies to young, aspiring nuns. All in one day.
Explain the Trinity. You've been a Catholic all your life.
Yeah, not a practicing one, I presume.
You got the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Ah, oh, it was the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
The three are one. Like a shamrock. Three leaves, but one leaf.
Let me try and summarize this. God is his Son, and his Son is God, but his Son moonlights as a Holy Ghost, a Holy Spirit, and a dove, and they all sent each other, even though they're all one and the same thing.
Pretty much. And this makes a whole of a lot of sense to a whole of a lot of people. I'm not one of them.
What I said, does that make any sense to you?
No, it does not. It really does not. But somehow people have made it make sense. And they've made an industry out of it. It's amazing.
No, but it makes no sense to anybody. That's why you have to have faith. I mean, if it made sense, it wouldn't have to be a religion, would it?
That's a sign from the Holy Spirit.
I'd be happy to consider you if you pass your exams.
Thank you.
Well, I wish you luck, Faith. Work hard.
I'm enjoying this.
Look, Charlie, some con men sell life insurance. The church sells afterlife insurance. Everyone thinks you might need it, and no one can prove you don't. Yeah. It's brilliant.
It's the biggest scheme in the history of mankind. It's amazing. It works. It is literally the best get-rich-quick scheme mankind has ever invented. If you want to be rich, get into religion. Start preaching. Because nobody can prove you wrong. Nobody knows what happens after death.
The church isn't selling anything, Brian.
Well, if the church isn't selling anything, how did it get to be so rich? Whenever there's a deep human need, there's money to be made.
That's how it is. Have you seen those televangelists? I watched a video of one of these American TV priests. He was going around saying, you guys have to give more money to the church because I need a new jet. I need a new private jet because I can't travel with the common demons. No, no. God wants me to have my fourth private jet. It was ridiculous. It's money to be made.
What happened to your arm?
I'm not sure.
Looks like a bullet wound to me.
How would you know?
I've seen bullet wounds. I've been a missionary.
Where?
East LA.
How can he be both a spirit and a man?
It just doesn't make sense. Just go with that. It's like when I tried to understand Back to the Future, the logic behind time travel. Just don't. Just say it makes no sense, and we'll just make that make sense.
All you need to know about the Trinity is this. God is like a shamrock. Small, green, and split three ways. Class dismissed.
Hello, Faith.
Who's that?
It's me, Brian.
Oh, Brian. Brian.
What are you doing here?
Looking for you.
Did you see us come in? Did anyone else?
Don't think so.
Oh, wish you hadn't followed us.
Thanks a lot.
It's for your own safety. You haven't seen me. You don't know I'm here, all right?
Can you stay with me for a bit?
No, I mean, if the nuns find me here, they'll tell the police. Besides, I don't want us to get too involved. I'm not available.
You're telling me you're married?
Yeah, I'm married. Sorry, I should have mentioned it.
Too bloody right. Why didn't you?
I only just thought of it. I only just thought of telling you it.
I'm going over to the church for confession.
That makes everything okay, does it?
In a way.
Lucky you.
I never want to see you again.
Sister Violetta, are you in here?
Yes. Listen, I...
What's wrong, sister?
She's just not used to your nudity, love.
It's so steamy in here. What are you doing in here?
Myself.
It's not right.
I know.
Today's my birthday, and the girls are giving me a party. Would you both like to come?
We'd love to.
Why do you carry those bags with you all the time?
They're very precious to us.
Whatever it is, it'll be quite safe over there with Sister Mary.
I don't understand why they don't just keep it in their cells, like under the bed.
I spoke to Faith. I told her I was married. She never wants to see me again.
Wow. Well, I mean, maybe that's for the best.
She said she was going to confess.
She's going to confess her own sins. Calm down.
She'll talk about the triad robbery. She'll name Case, then us.
Don't panic. Priests never tell anyone what they hear in their confessional.
When you tell her to go to the police.
As soon as he leaves, you go in.
Hello, sister.
Hello, Seamus. Is there somewhere nice and quiet we could have a little talk?
Oh, certainly, sister.
Bless me, Father, for I have sinned. I've become involved with a gangster called Brian. I have lustful feelings about him.
You do?
I think I love him.
You love him?
Well, if you love him, then those feelings are okay. They're just human.
He says he doesn't love me.
Perhaps he's just saying that.
And he's a married man. But when we kissed, I felt all warm and funny inside.
I wondered if you'd like to talk about your desires. Father Pearson told me that you could hardly keep your hands to yourself.
I'm a man. That's why I flirt a little.
Well, love, there is a difference between flirting and not being able to keep your hands to yourself.
The way I see it, sex is allowed. It's the doctrine of original sin. We're all born sinful, except for Jesus, who was perfect, of course. And he was sent to save us. But how can he save us unless we're sinning? That's how Christianity works. That's why it suits so many people.
I mean, he's not wrong. If you want to believe all this stuff, then you might as well take it with a grain of salt and do it. You know, keep on sinning so Jesus can save you over and over again. So you can be saved so many times that eventually you go to heaven.
So is it true that if you commit a sin out of fear, it's not necessarily a sin after all?
Sounds right to me. Okay, thanks for dropping by.
Aren't you going to give me absolution for my sins?
I was just coming to that. I absolve you in the name of the Holy Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Shamrock.
Spirit.
Spirit, sorry.
Thank you, Father.
You're welcome.
She loves me. And I've got to go to Brazil forever. Maybe I can stay here somehow.
Listen! We have to leave. Either on a plane to Brazil, or feet first.
Can we have our bags, please? I've put them away in a nice, safe place.
Where?
She can't remember.
Over there in that cupboard.
It won't open.
Of course not. It's locked.
Lucky I kept some aside.
Maybe Faith went home.
We gotta warn her before she gets into trouble.
Little bit too late.
Who's got our money?
I don't know, do I?
We saw you with the man who took our money.
He hasn't got it. He works for Mr. Casey. Casey's health club. He'll have it.
Oh, honey, if I was this blind, I literally would walk into Specsavers or any kind of glass store and I would buy myself some glasses. This is so unsafe.
We'd like something to shave with, please.
We want men's razors. We're very hairy.
You've only got the one ticket for Rio for tomorrow. What about the day after? No, I'll pay for both of them now. Yes, American Express.
What exactly are you looking for?
A missing person. Name of Charlie. He was last seen in this street. And his friend who was with him, name of Brian Hope.
They didn't come here. I'm so sorry to hurry you.
Charlie. Sorry. Force of habit.
Yeah, I was gonna say, you can't steal from the church. I mean, I know the church is filthy rich, but it has an extra holiness to it.
Sister Liz, could I talk to you?
Mr. Norris.
Oh, my God.
It's about the theft of a large sum of money, possibly stolen by person or persons within this convent.
You'd better come to my office.
Who's that geezer?
He looks like the law.
That man's the auditor.
Oh, is that all?
I've done a terrible thing.
A great deal of money is missing from the Catholic Drug Rehabilitation Clinic.
I've lost £50,000 on the horses.
Sister, what the F? So you're an alcoholic and a gambler?
Some you win and some you lose.
Who knows? Next week you might win it all back again.
Sister Mary.
She's the clinic's administrator. She drinks rather heavily, I'm afraid, and apparently she's gambled it all away on the horses.
But that's criminal.
That money was next year's budget for the drug rehabilitation clinic.
So you're going to report Sister Mary to the police?
I can't. She's repented.
What does she mean that she can't, turn her in? This is a criminal offence. What, are nuns above the law?
What are you doing?
I'm gonna find Faith. Hello? Faith?
Oh shit, it's Abbott and Morley.
Wasn't that lucky?
Back to the convent.
What about our habits?
What about the money? What about staying alive?
Oh, Sister Mary, honey. Oh no, oh no, oh God, oh God. No! Oh my God, she's panicking!
Come on, go!
Are you sure you saw two men? Do you think I imagined it?
Sweetie, you probably passed out from drinking. Yeah, you might have.
Scotch?
Yes.
We have to try and get this problem under control. Now go to bed.
We've escaped from Abbott and Morley and the Triads and Case. And where have we found sanctuary? Here, in the House of God.
Are you kidding me?
No. I think God's going to get us out of this alive.
Well, I hope you won't be relying on him totally, because we've still got to break into that bleeding cupboard.
God helps those who help themselves, Brian. Now, what God wants us to do now, to wait till everyone's asleep, break into that cupboard, take the money, and go.
Wow, you read God's mind like an open book.
Ah! Ah! Oh, it's only me. Oh. I've come to get you. It's my party.
Are these women really serious about becoming nuns? I'm not sure. Because drinking and partying and stuff, this isn't really, nunnish. What's the word? Nunnery? I don't know. You guys know what I mean.
Got any booze?
Sure. We're a bit anti-nun. But you two, quite different.
No, we're just the same.
Yeah, Jesus approves.
Wasn't it gruesome about that girl who was shot in the street today?
Who?
Her name's Faith. They brought her in here. Then kidnapped by Chinese gangsters. Then she escaped. Now she's in hospital.
It's long after visiting hours.
But I'm her spiritual advisor.
You can't say no to a nun.
All right. As it's you, sister.
You must be Faith's father.
That's right, sister.
How is she?
Well, she's got a bullet wound.
Bullet wound?
Apparently, she's been involved with some gangster called Brian.
Oh, dear. Oh, dearie me.
If I ever get my hands on this Brian.
Violence never solves anything. You must learn to forgive.
Yeah, and you also must learn how to recognize a male's face from a woman's. They're quite different, most often. Well, they were in the 90s, not so much now.
May I have a word with Faith alone?
Sure.
No, sister. My glass is there.
No. You're not seriously hurt.
Who cares?
I care.
The man I'm in love with doesn't. I wish I was dead.
Sweetie, if you're in love with a man who you think doesn't care, you want to kill yourself? No, honey, you need to have more self-respect than that. Do not hang your self-worth on a man. That's just nonsense.
Got to take her with us.
In one word, no way.
Why not?
The Triads have followed her here. They're watching out for us. Tomorrow we get up early, we get the money, and we go.
Your face.
It's all stubby! You've got a beard! You're a man! Man of a man!
She's just off her rockers, my God! Yeah, you need to forget about Faith and just leave.
Grab that ass!
Don't you think you'd better explain?
We took it from the Triad gang. They're drug traffickers.
You're men?
Oh, yeah.
And we desperately want to get out of organized crime.
Hands up!
Ah!
Oh, the police. The police!
You bet!
Wait! I want absolution.
Absolution is only possible with repentance.
I repent.
If you repent, hand that stolen money over to me.
Why should you get it?
The church? I mean, the church never has enough money.
I really do repent. Really.
I don't know whether I can believe all this.
That's your problem, sister.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, you are already covering for an alcoholic sister who spent money on gambling, which is illegal, by the way.
I found him!
This would certainly not be a possibility in London today. With the traffic, oh no.
Where?
Trying to follow him. Charlie's quite a driver.
Going the wrong way.
To the airport?
To the hospital.
We are going to the airport!
Hello, sister.
Here are your glasses.
Brian! Why are you dressed like that?
I'll explain everything.
Oh. Ow! You bloody liar!
I'm not lying. I love you.
I don't care. You're married.
I'm not married. Ow! Why did you do that?
Because you lied to her.
You told me you didn't love me and you do!
She's making out with a nun. Well, not actually, but still, you know, the people around her might think so.
Which ward is Faith Thomas in? Reason to believe she's being visited by a couple of so-called nuns.
Case is here. Well, I've got to sort this out.
Charlie!
Come on!
No!
Well, if you don't leave, you're going to end up in jail anyway, so you won't be able to be with Faith.
I'm going to stay here and take what's coming to me.
You mean jail?
I suppose so.
Get that stretcher! Hide the bags!
Hang on! Tell them we went that way!
This is the most exciting thing that's ever happened to these women.
Oh! Oh, gotcha, fuckers! Stop! Or I'll shoot! Goodbye, boys. Cardiac arrest! What is your gun, sir?
Oops, you brought gun to a hospital? Not a good idea.
There's only one bag.
We lost one!
Doesn't that bag look familiar to you, Sister Mary?
Any suggestions?
You're not gonna pretend to be nurses.
Wait! I must seem straight.
Yes, I.
God, look, it's him!
Oh, that's Brian!
Freeze! Take those dresses off!
We're not allowed to strip search, were we?
No, you're not. They're nuns. They're holy. Well, are those the... Oh, okay. Oh, these are nurses. Well, they're dressed like nuns. They're holy.
I said, take them off.
Well, this cannot be comfortable working as a nurse, sweetie. This is more what you wear when you're going to seduce your man into bed.
I'm scared, you! I want my money and
stuff. Thank God.
Yeah.
It's enough money for 10 drug rehabilitation clinics.
Yeah, just for God's sake, make sure that Sister Mary doesn't get her hands on it, because she will blow it all away on booze and gambling.
Next, please.
We've booked 2 seats, but we need 3.
What flight and what name?
The name is...
Security alert. If anyone asks for tickets in the name of McManus or Hope, we want to talk to them.
Wait, she went on her own?
Some champagne, perhaps. Or some caviar?
Okay, let's talk about it. Alright, that was me watching Nuns on the Runs. It was good. I didn't realize it was a British film, but you know, it was good nevertheless. And British films are great, they're funny. I honestly think this is the actor that play Hagrid. Am I right? Am I wrong? Just let me know. If you guys don't know what I'm talking about the giant in Harry Potter. I think this is the actor that played Hagrid. So, those two guys, phenomenal. And the woman, she was funny as well. Can't remember her name. But overall, the story was funny. I mean, you can't really go wrong with films about, you know, bad guys disguising as nuns. Or like in Sister Act, when she had to hide out as a nun. You can't really go wrong with it. So, that always, that's a good comedy. That's a good comedy. I would say 3.5 out of 5. If you guys like this video, give it a thumbs up, don't forget to subscribe, hit that notification bell if you want to be notified, and share this video with everyone you know and so many more, so we can bring more people on this journey of ours of discovering all these great films. And I'll see you in the next video.